How can you give them ROI? You can give them ROI by taking the same event and moving it from a live medium into a recorded medium. So you can put it on television. You can put it, some part of it on radio. You can put it as a webcast. You can episodically make it. And we realized that this was a way that you could actually find a new revenue source. We created a brand new revenue source. And we started doing television. Television was in our DNA. I was a trained television mass communication student. So I knew enough people in the business. But we ended up creating a whole new business. The 30 television shows we made everything from a brand activation that became a television show to a Toyota event with Sonu Nigam performing as a television show on Star Plus to Aamir Khan being a brand ambassador of Toyota for a short time. And he had one day to give where he said, okay, I'm going to be in Goa and the winners of Toyota can come and spend a day with us. Now, we were asked to only do the event. We were doing this event in Goa. Everybody was coming, all these people. And we turned to the brand and said, let's shoot it. And they were like, arre yaar, shoot karke kya karenge? We said, nahi, shoot karte hain. Aamir Khan hai, kuch niklega. We spent a day and we shot with Aamir Khan. We took some parts of the footage and showed it to Star Plus. Star Gold ran the footage for free. They didn't charge. Television channels normally charge you. They didn't charge. It was one of their most watched television episodes because Aamir Khan never used to give interviews. Aamir Khan never used to be out there in the open. You only saw his film and you never saw his life. But here was a little glimpse into his life that we could show. The client loved the fact that there was such a unique ROI that they got. They got a return on their investment that was absolutely unique. So our content division actually started through that. So if you're really looking to create profit out of something which is passion, find other people who are passionate and make them your partners. I can't do it all myself. The guy who used to shoot my television show became the head of content for us and still is with us. You will come across people who you cannot replicate. If you come across a person in this business that you can't replicate, make them your partner. The reason I have been able to run multiple successful businesses is because the first thing I do is I hire my own replacement. You must hire your own replacement. I know it's very difficult. You'll feel, arre yaar, agar maine apna replacement hire kar liya, toh phir toh main redundant ho jaunga. But redundancy is what actually gives you the ability to do new things. So when I met Sukrit Singh, who was three batches my junior, and he was working with me, I realized here's a guy who knows, he can sketch anything. Sukrit can sit in front of you and say, and yes, set it. And I'm like, oh my God. And those were the days, remember, 1998, 2000, we didn't have 3D Max and all the stuff which we have today. Everything used to be done by hand. So he could sketch everything by hand. I could not do that. He had done theater production. I could not do that. I immediately made Sukrit my partner. He was a junior of mine. Now, in this business, there are 100 times when you're sitting across the table from someone knowing that you can exploit them. Okay, we are not all Mahatma Gandhi. We are out to make money. But the minute I realized, and you know, I have been in those conversations as well where I have earned off someone's talent. But here was a talent I didn't have. And I said, this is a person who will be a big support and a great collaborator. Sukrit became a junior partner at Encompass. He had a small percentage of equity. The other important thing I'll tell you is if you really want to be profitable, and I know it sounds, and I sometimes sound saintly on these things, but don't cheat someone of what you promise them. In our business, we promise the sky to the client. We promise the sky to the artist. We promise the earth and the moon to everyone who's working with us, but we don't deliver. And what you don't realize, because you come and say, time nahi tha. Sorry, it didn't happen. Next time. You build a reputation on these things. We produced a television show in 2009 called Palampur Express. It was a 104-episode show. It was 8 lakhs an episode. We were losing a lakh and a half on every episode. We paid everybody. And even today, there are people I meet in the industry who turn and say, if you're making a show, we are willing to give you stuff for free because you paid. Okay, it was a loss. It was a huge loss. It was such a big loss that at one point, Sukrit came and said, if you make any more of these television shows, I'll shoot you. It was that bad. You know, you just have to learn to live up to things. It's very, very important. So, one part of preserving profit is just living up to what you commit to people, which very often we don't do. Finding the right partners has always been an important thing, which I did very, very early. The second thing is, as you grow older, there will be things that you can't do. When you can't do them, find people who can do them and make them again your partners. So, when I invested in this digital agency in 2011, I was in fact telling some people saying that I actually took the agency papers, that agency papers, to JWT, who had bought Encompass. And I said, you must buy this agency. This agency is going to grow. And they were like, you know, it's too small. It's because we're billing 1 crore rupees. Why will we do it? And it'll be too much paperwork. I said, if you don't invest, I'm going to invest, because these people are doing things that I get excited by. And if nothing else, if nothing happens, the journey will be unique. We'll travel well together. And that's the kind of stuff that we did. We sold this agency in Jan for a phenomenal price. It is considered to be one of India's largest deals in the digital content domain, which we sold. Imagine the same principal could have bought it in 2011 for 100th the price. But because at the right time you invest and you follow through. So tomorrow, if you find somebody who comes to you with a unique idea at your event who needs some funding, don't turn them away. Find 5 people. Who knows whether TEEMA can do this? Who knows whether you can actually get together and find somebody who's bringing something unique to Hyderabad? This is tech city. This is a city where people bring unique things all the time in terms of ideas. Can you as an industry sometimes get together and become a part of that? It just might be unique. So there are various kind of hacks that are possible. The one other thing that I feel is important is, we call it, you know, you've got to figure out how you can provide a depth of relationship and a width of services. You only do events today. Today, we became Geometry and Compass because we realized that we have got deep relationships with clients for over 10 years. Most of Encompass's clients are clients who've been with us over 10 years. But all we do with them are events, conventions, conferences, couple of big arena sporting events, etc., and some amount of brand activation. And we sat and said, how do we grow this? And we realized that with the same client for 10 years, if you've done all of this, what have you earned? You've earned trust. Event people, when they deliver, earn a lot of trust with the client. And the client is willing to extend that trust. Do you have new services? So we took over this company called Geometry, which was an Ogilvy company, only because we felt that Geometry would bring in new services. Today we do shopper marketing, we do deep rural, and when the INB ministry out of Delhi was doing something called, they wanted to talk about digital knowledge to people, about, you know, all these apps that were coming and how monetize, after demonetization there was this whole talk of what do you do in terms of digital apps and, you know, your card linking, Aadhaar linking, Paytm, all of these things were happening, and they turned and said, what can we do to educate people? And our deep rural division, which till that point didn't exist, came and said, we will create this property called Digidhan Mela. Digidhan Mela, to the last count I remember, has happened in 3,500 villages. It was a service we didn't have. We found the service and we partnered, and that's why Geometry and Compass happened. Partnerships in this business, people are very scared of. What if the other person makes more money? What if he makes a fool of me? What if he runs away with the client? Major issues. Many people have these issues or whatever. You have to get over that fear. If you really want to be profitable, you have to try some hacks. You've got to try some new things. And what we do, so for example, let me give you an example. So Pepsi is a company where Encompass used to do some amount of work, and there was another WPP company called Dialogue Factory, which used to do a lot of work. And we used to turn and say that Dialogue Factory, because they come from Group M, come with a media plan and activation. We come with a sexy event, but we have no media. And we realized that between the two of us, we were doing about 80% of the business at Pepsi. But there was 20% going to other people. So we contacted these people, we got them together and said, I'll tell you what, let's form a new team. Let's form something called Team One. And Team One will go and service Pepsi. And it'll be you and us together, because you understand media, you understand activation, we understand events, we understand content. Let's bring these services together. What we'll do is simple. We will build this business to the client. Whatever profit is made, once the profit is made, we will sit with our balance sheets open, put the cost of the business, whatever was the cost of the team in its entirety, into the cost. Whatever is left, we'll split 50-50. No, you are 60, I am 40. You know, all of this equations keep changing. Bada ajeeb lagta hai. Someday you feel you did more work, someday somebody else will feel they did more work. It was very clear. What it did was, it suddenly protected the entire business for us. We became the sole guys servicing the entire business. So technically, from whatever we were earning, our earning went up. And now we became two partners who started working together. That formula has worked so well that we've implemented that formula in multiple other places. So there is this ability to be able to do this with people who are rivals. Remember, there's a phrase that I came up with many years ago. I call it colleptition. Colleptition kya hai? Collaborate and competition. Dono ko jod do. Compete with people on some occasions, collaborate with them on others. It's great fun, it's great learning, right? So there are times that I have repicked up the phone and called E-Factors. I'm not in the wedding business, but I've called Samit saying, Samit, I'm doing a huge convention that is happening in Gujarat. It's for 10,000 people. I can't handle this aspect. Can you come in and do this, this, this? I came on board. We worked together. We tried a new partner. We understood how to do it. You will only forge these. And because I'm saying this particularly because you are the association in a state currently. If you want to go bigger, you must find these collaborations. Seven of you can combine from across the country and make the biggest event company in the country, I can assure you. You can do that. You must aim for that. You must have some unique services that you offer. Because our canvas is still wide open. There is no agency in the country that is over 500 crores. If this business is meant to be, they say anything between 5,000 to 10,000 crores, I think that's a bullshit number. It is a lot more than that. You all know that as well. But imagine that. There is a large, large chunk of this business. This business, if to become profitable, also requires two more things. And these are the last two things I'll tell you, and then we'll just do a Q&A. So that, you know, if you have any questions, I'd love to actually take that and make it more relevant. One is people. Your biggest problem in this business is people. People join you, they work with you for a while, they leave you, they set up their own agencies, people get worried, they've got all these issues. What will happen? It's a huge issue. I'll tell you a joke that I used the other day when Viscraft opened this Academy of Weddings in Bombay. So a CFO came up to his CEO and turned and said, my God, we're spending so much money on training. What if this person after all the training leaves? And the CEO turned and said, what if without the training he stays? If without the training the person stays, look at what you're doing to yourself. You will constantly do yourself a disservice. So train, train, train. You know, Avinash is an ex-Encompassian. He learned something with us. When he does something, it makes us really happy and proud. Tomorrow, if I have to do something, I know he has my ethic. He understands how I work. Encompass at one time went through a crisis. 2009, you remember when the meltdown happened. We just sold our company. We had numbers to do. We were going through a terrible time. We had a staff of over 400 and we had to get rid of 100 people. 100 logon ko sack karna is not an easy job. So what did we do? We actually went to each of the cities and we told the teams we were working with saying, listen, we can't afford to have you on payroll. But I'll tell you, there's an opportunity. The opportunity is, why don't you set up your own agency in the city? You set up an agency in the city, whatever work we get, we will give to you. So the months we have work, we'll give you work, but the other months you'll need to figure out how to be an entrepreneur. I think out of the five offices that we were at that point, because we were just wanting, we had seven offices and we had to say we were only going to go down to two. Out of the five, four people became entrepreneurs who are running their own successful businesses today. They are our local partners. We use them everywhere. We in fact proudly call them Encompass Zip, like a zip code. So we say they're like an Encompass Zip. And they're in that city because they have our work ethos. They understand what to do. If you have people and you can train them, it's great. If you have people who want to leave you and move on because they want to do new things, stay in touch. We have a WhatsApp group which is called Encompass Wasian. It's the funniest group. They all talk. They sometimes will have celebrate birthdays. They'll celebrate, arey, humne ye show saath mein kiya tha. They'll meet up for a drink. It makes us very happy. We have almost been an institution with over 1,000 plus people who passed out from us. We're not an event company. We're an institution. That's how we treat it. And that's how we have grown the people and built that ethic. And that's what happens. That group makes me extremely happy. We celebrated 20 years. We didn't have a party because we had limited budgets. And Sukrit turned and said, I will only do a party if everyone who was ever a part of Encompass was sent an invitation and we could host all of them. And we realized that would be 1,000 people. So we said, listen, we can't actually call 1,000 people and do something. We're still fighting, saying, no, we want to do it. And we know, but that is the joy. If you want to create something sustainable for a period of time, profit, you know, you've heard of the golden goose story. You can cut its neck once, or you can keep waiting for it to do things. And I think sustainable profitability actually comes from these kind of efforts, from building systems, from training people. And the last thing which I wanted to leave you with is saying, from taking challenges. 2010, we had done all kinds of events except stadium events. We'd done one or two client stadium events, but they were not stadium events. When we got offered to the IPL, I think that was, this was 2018, 2014. Before that, we were very shy of doing stadium events. We used to be like, kyun karenge? What's the point? Why will we do it? Or whatever, etc. You know, we did the 2014 IPL. It is still, I can relive every moment of that show because it was a nightmare. It rained and it rained. And I had Hrithik Roshan and I had Shahid Kapoor and Anushka Sharma and Farhan Akhtar. Everybody waiting backstage saying, don't worry, we are with you. We'll support you. The stage was slippery. One part of the stage broke live. The LEDs didn't work. On television, it looked like shit. Live in the stadium, it still worked or whatever. We couldn't accommodate the local kids who we had in that city to come out with the parade. They wrote on social media saying, what a terrible agency. Humne teen din kaam kiya. In logon ne hamare march pass bhi nahi karai. Hate them. I didn't sleep, I think, for 2 to 3 nights. I felt so bad because, you know, failing is something I don't like to do. And, you know, when you get used to winning over a period of time, failure suddenly hits you very badly. But it didn't just affect me. It affected everyone at the agency. Everybody felt equally bad. And you know what happened? The next year, we went and pitched again. And when the pitch happened, everybody in the room turned and said, ah, acha, you all have come. And everybody had that snigger on their face saying, phir aa gaye. We didn't get it. We went again the next year. This year, we went and they said, phir aa gaye. Sir, aa gaye. Seekh saak kya hai? 2 saal mein kuch seekh bhi liya hai. We've done this, we've done this, we've done this, we've done this. And the turn said, really? Okay, so what are you going to do this time? And we blew their minds. We'd come up with some fabulous creative ideas. So they turned and said, okay, fabulous. We want to give you this ceremony, but let me tell you one thing. 2 years ago, you did one opening ceremony in one city. This is the 10th year of IPL. In 8 days, you have to do 10 opening ceremonies. Not one, 10 opening ceremonies. In my pitch, I had turned and said, sir, if anybody comes and says they can do 10 opening ceremonies in 8 days, they are bullshitting you. But we're sitting there with an offer saying, can you do it? And we said, we will not commit to you right now. We need 24 hours. In 24 hours, we picked up the phone on everyone we knew, from our artist manager friends to Dot. So the team that had gone out was about 50 people who were doing this event. Many others were doing other events. And when they came back, all we did was we bought these bats. And, you know, when people entered our office that day, we locked the office from outside. So when this team came back, and we put up the shutter and everybody in the office was holding a bat up like this to give them a champion's welcome. And even today, every one person in that team comes to me and says, you know, in my life, I've done bahut cheeze dekhi hain. Bada show dekha, Shah Rukh Khan dekha, Amitabh Bachchan dekha. Par us din jaisa mujhe hero feel hua na, kisi ko nahi hua. And that's why I know that those people will always be a part of what we do. So you don't just profit in money. You profit in the deeds you do, you profit in the people you create, you profit in the legacy you leave behind. And that's all I want to leave you with. Thank you.